Holcomb facing some pushback from conservatives, but of course Braun facing scrutiny this week as well. Wasn't long after he issued that statement that he made national news, as we mentioned earlier, all because of what he said about interracial marriage in a call with reporters during this very busy week in the nation's capital. Statements that he has since attempted to walk back. That press conference started off with a discussion on the nomination hearings for Judge Ketanji Brown Jackson, the first black woman to be nominated for the U.S. Supreme Court, which I asked Braun about as that call with reporters got started on Tuesday.
Might we see some Republicans cross over and vote to confirm Judge Jackson?
Well, I don't think there'll be any Democrat voting against her. I think there are probably three or four Republicans that would maybe lean that direction. But if the case is made that with prior opinions at lower court levels and her answers to what she wants to accomplish, they generally are understated if you're talking about judicial activism. Everyone basically, in a perfunctory way, will say, I'm going to be neutral, look at the merits of the case. I think that'll determine whether it's purely a partisan vote or not. We'll see what happens.
All right. From there, other reporters had a chance to ask Braun questions as well about cases like Roe v. Wade and whether Braun would support decisions like that being overturned and left up to the states. That's when Dan Cardin from the Northwest Indiana Times asked the senator if that theory should also apply to cases like Loving versus Virginia, which dealt with interracial marriage.
You would be okay with the Supreme Court leaving the question of interracial marriage to the states?
Yes, I think that that's something that if you're not wanting the Supreme Court to weigh in on issues like that, you're not going to be able to have your cake and eat it too. I think that's hypocritical.
All right, after he made that original comment, Indiana Democrats issued a statement saying, quote, Mike Braun's words and views are not only un-American, but beneath any respectable person wishing to hold public office. The United States Supreme Court has affirmed many times that marriage equality in our country extends to any committed couple. Now, later that day, Senator Braun issued a statement saying he, quote, misunderstood the line of questioning and that, quote, the Constitution prohibits discrimination of any kind based on race. That is not something that is even up for debate. He says, I condemn racism in any form. Of course, we will talk about it all with our panel coming up. Today, we're also following the latest on the war in Ukraine. This week, the Secretary of State now officially accusing Russia of war crimes as President Biden meets with NATO allies in Brussels.
We also will welcome 100,000 Ukrainians to the United States with a focus on reuniting families. And we will invest $320 million to bolster democratic resilience and defend human rights in Ukraine and neighboring countries.
Governor Holcomb also headed overseas this weekend, where he'll meet with Ukrainian refugees here in the coming days. Coming up, we're going to talk about the life and legacy of former Secretary of State Madeleine Albright as we chat with a Hoosier who knew her well. Plus, what's next after the governor's veto of the transgender sports bill amidst a lot of criticism from within his own party, including from Senator Mike Braun, who, as we mentioned, faced controversy of his own this week. We'll talk about it all with our panel straight ahead.